Father,
Baba,
your people are gathered here. Your people are connected to this program in one way or the other. According to the word of prophecy that has gone forth for all those who will connect to the match program, the anointing to trample upon every serpent and scorpion, the anointing to march forward in a new way. Father, let it come upon your children in the name of Jesus. Lay your hands upon us. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Let's have a seat and take our Bibles. God bless you. Today is a 3-in-1 program. We want to go into the words of God now. Then we're going to prayers.
Then you know how long Badura.
After that,
then you read.
We'll now start the firstborn deliverance program. If you are a firstborn heir and you are set to repossess your possession, can I hear you shouting a loud hallelujah? If you are not a firstborn and you are here and you are ready to possess your possession, let me hear you shouting a louder hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
Your unstoppable testimony. My unstoppable testimony. Your unstoppable testimony. In Acts chapter 4,
I read
from verse 1. Acts of
Apostles,
chapter 4, from verse 1.
That is a kini.
Let the Yoruba leaders just follow us. Acts chapter 4 from verse 1. And as they spake unto the people, the priest and the captain of the temple and the Sadducees came upon them, being grieved that they taught the people and preached through Jesus the resurrection from the dead. And they laid hands on them and put them in the hold unto the next day, for it was eventide. Howbeit, many of them which had the word believed, and the number of the men were about 5,000. Their first message had brought 5,000 people. These were the disciples. And it came to pass on the morrow that their rulers and elders and scribes, and Annas the high priest, and Caiaphas, and John, and Alexander, and as many as were of the kindred of the high priest, were gathered together at Jerusalem. And when they had set them in the midst, they asked, by what power or by what name have you done this? Then Peter, filled with the Holy Ghost, said unto them, you rulers of the people and elders of Israel, if we this day be examined of the good deed done to the impotent man, by what means is made whole, be it known unto you all and to all the people of Israel, that by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead, even by him does this man stand before you whole. This is the stone which was set at naught of you builders, which has become the head of the corner. Neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. Now when they saw the boldness of Peter and John, and perceived that they were unlearned and ignorant men, they marveled. You shall become a mysterious wonder.
Oh dear,
the Bible says they looked at these illiterates talking. They marveled. And they took knowledge of them that they had been with Jesus. And beholding the man which was healed standing with them, they could say nothing against it. Your matter shall go beyond explanation. In Acts chapter 5,
iṣẹ́ apostle orí karùn-ún,
verse 17.
Ẹsẹ̀ kẹtàdínlógún.
They have been arrested again.
Wọ́n ti mú wọn.
Again, second time.
Nígbà mìíràn.
Then the high priest rose up, and all they that are with them, Acts 5:17.
Iṣẹ́ apostle orí karùn-ún, ẹsẹ̀ kẹtàdínlógún.
Which is the sect of the Sadducees, which were filled with indignation. They were very angry. And laid their hands on the apostles and put them in the common prison. But the angel of the Lord by night opened the prison doors, brought them forth, and said, "Go, stand and speak in the temple to the people all the words of this life." And when they heard that, they entered into the temple early in the morning and taught. But the high priest came and they that were with him, and they called the council together again, and all the senate of the children of Israel, and sent to the prison to have them brought. But when the officers came and found them not in the prison, they returned and told, saying, "The prison truly we found was shut with all safety, and the keeper standing without before the door. But when we had opened, we found no man within." Now when the high priest and the captains of the people and the chief priests heard these things, they doubted of them whereunto this will go. Then came one and told them, saying, "Behold, the men who you put in prison are standing in the temple and teaching the people." Then when the captain with the officers and brought them without violence, they now give them respect. Your enemies shall respect you. They brought them now without violence. For they fear the people, lest they should have been stoned. And when they have brought them, they set them in the council and the high priest and asked them, saying, verse 28, "Did not we straightly command you that you should not teach in this name? And behold, you have filled Jerusalem with your doctrine, and you intend to bring this man's blood upon us." Then Peter and the other apostle answered and said, "We ought to obey God rather than men." And they talked and talked and talked. Verse 33. When they had that, they were cut to the heart, and they took counsel to slay them. They wanted to kill them. Then stood up one in the council, a Pharisee named Gamaliel, a doctor of the law, who had reputation among all the people, and commanded to put the apostles forth a little space. And he said, "Ye men of Israel, take heed to yourselves what you intend to do as touching these men. For before these days rose up Judas, boasting himself to be somebody, to whom a number of men about 400 joined themselves, who were slain, and all as many as obeyed him were scattered and brought to naught. And after this rose up Judas of Galilee in the days of taxing, and drew away much people after him. He also perished. All, even as many as obeyed him, were dispersed. And now I say unto you, refrain from these men. Leave them alone.
If you want to live.
If this counsel or this work be of men, it will come to naught. But if it be of God, ye cannot overthrow it. Lest haply ye be found even to fight against God." And to him they agreed. And when they had called the apostles and beaten them, they commanded that they should not speak in the name of Jesus, and let them go. And they departed from the presence of the council after being beaten, rejoicing that they were counted worthy to suffer shame for his name. And daily in the temple and in every house, they ceased not to teach and preach Jesus Christ. I've read you a lot of passages of scripture. Listen very carefully to me now. Wherever God has a purpose in his mind to move his children forward, there is always an opposition. Unto every man or woman of destiny, there is always a conspiracy of evil men against them. As soon as the Almighty decides to do something about the situation of man, there will be an immediate opposition from hellfire. This time there is a manifestation of God's power brewing up.
that
there is always a gang up from the spirit realm. Information for somebody here today from heaven. I have information for somebody here who is ready to claim it. That your testimony is unstoppable. Listen to me. The last thing I should tell you, that you are entering into something that hell cannot stop. You are stepping into something. Yes, there will be gang up. Yes, there will be opposition. Yes, there will be council meetings. There will be coven conferences. There will be plenty of deliberation to stop you. There will be a carefully planned agenda to put a stop to your progress. What I want to tell you, if you are here today, you are connected to us, that your testimony is unstoppable. In the name of Jesus, a sovereign. Shout this man, say, listen to me, Satan!
You go, you wait, you go,
my testimony is unstoppable. By the power, in the blood of Jesus, open your mouth and say, ask him to listen to you.
We wait for you.
Listen to me, Satan! My testimony is unstoppable. By the power, in the blood of Jesus. Declare his name and
prayer.
Masatina kaya bushente raba. Amen.
Amen.
Agreed. Agreed.
As you go.
For several years, you are here, you are listening to me.
Oh, Ami, Ombami.
Many things have held you down. You don't even know what they are.
Oh, dear, man, God, okay.
But right now, hear me and hear me well. You are entering into what no devil can stop or kill. For your testimony is unstoppable. In the name of Jesus. A louder amen. I have some strange words for some people here. The Lord said I should tell such people that the power of God shall arise for your sake and provoke confusion and chaos in the camp of your enemy. Listen, that the agents of darkness,
say I will disappear,
they will struggle hard, but they will not be able to understand or predict or explain what is going to happen to you. Listen. You are here. You can hear me well.
Oh, I mean,
you can go and write down what I'm saying now. The shock and the surprise of your breakthrough shall kill your enemies. Amen. For
victory,
you will become poison to the enemy. You will become a book they cannot read. Because all the satanic bullets that have been fired against you shall double in power and backfire. Let that come over here like thunder. Listen.
Sorry.
The lesson I should tell you, that you worry yourself too much. The story of
Pharaoh
shall befall those hindering your progress. Not only that, the satanic warehouse and bank holding your breakthrough shall catch fire and release your breakthrough. I have information for somebody. The Lord said the Goliath that has been confronting your destiny shall die shamefully. Whatever problems the enemy is bringing your way shall develop terminal disease and die. And the God who is more than enough shall over answer your prayers. Sit down a little bit. Always from the beginning. Whenever God has things to do like this, quickly, some council meeting will gather. There will be a conspiracy to stop it. Why is your testimony unstoppable? Because it does not depend on human beings. It does not depend on human energy. It does not depend on human wisdom. It does not depend on human knowledge. It does not depend on mathematics. It does not depend on any lawyer. It does not depend on any doctor. The apostles, although they were unimportant, unrecognized, uneducated, unlettered, unlearned. God decided to walk through them. They were feeble, but they were unstoppable. They appear to be nothing. People think they are nothing. But these men dismantle those who think they are something. They dismantle them. They made the priest useless. There was priests in the temple. People were not going there to listen to their sermons. They were interested in these men who raised the lame men. When the rushing mighty wind came to Jerusalem, on the day of Pentecost, it did not scatter anybody's house. It was only looking for one house. The house where the apostle was gathered. The rushing mighty wind had an address from heaven. He jumped over several houses and went to where they were gathered. So the Lord said, I should tell you that miracles, signs, virtues, blessings will locate your address. They killed James. They arrested Peter. But it was unstoppable. They could not stop it. Your testimony shall be unstoppable. By your life, Satan is going to regret. That's your testimony. They can't stop it. They can't reduce it. Closed doors cannot stop it. But God cannot lock it. It is unstoppable. When the move of that gospel started, there was somebody called
Saul.
He tried to stop it. But what happened? He himself was captured by what he wanted to stop. The captain of opposition was captured. The captain became a captive. The man that was attacking it became a servant of that move. Any enemy that is not ready to settle with you shall be embarrassed and disgraced. Because your testimony is unstoppable. It's 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 unstoppable. In the name of Jesus. But then, you need, number one, surrender your life to Jesus. You need, number two, to repent from all known sins. You need, number three, let holy anger rise within you. Pray with holy anger. One, surrender your life to Jesus. Two, repent from all nonsense. Three, let holy anger rise from within you. Four, pray until something happens here. This is a very short meeting. And the meeting will soon come to an end. The few minutes you want to spend, pray until something happens. And you will see what the God will begin to do from your life and from this
problem.
Something is about to start that no enemy can stop. Listen carefully.
Dada.
The next two power changers, when you are coming, come with the picture of your children. That's why we want to start. We're going to do deliverance from evil history and childhood problems. If your children have been giving you stress, trouble, they're not serving God, they're worrying you, come with a picture. If you are still trusting God for the children, bring your own picture. Whether you are married or not does not matter. Once you believe you will have children, bring your own picture. With these next two farmer singers, deliverance from evil history. Time to cut off your children from any bad thing that happened to you. Deliverance from evil history. and deliverance of childhood problems. That's what I told you. That something is about to start, which no devil can stop. All eyes closed. You see, if you are here this morning and you are not born again, I want to help you flow into what we are going to flow into. Run quickly to the altar here, or any of the two altars at the back. Come and surrender your life to Jesus, so that you too will have an unstoppable testimony. Jesus is waiting for you here. Read very, very quickly. We still have plenty of things to do here today. Just come and surrender your life to Jesus. Very quickly, very quickly. Those of you at the altars, I congratulate you. You've taken the most important decision in life. And I decree upon your life that you have taken this step, your testimony shall be unstoppable. Close your hearts. Say what I'm going to say after. Say, Father,
Baba,
in the name of Jesus, I come before you now. I know that you care for me. Father,
Baba,
I know that you sent Jesus,
Jesus
to die for my sins. Lord Jesus,
Jesus Oluwa,
forgive me all my sins. In the name of Jesus, enter into my life. Take control of my life. In Jesus' name. Amen. I'm going to pray with you now. Father, I release your children unto your holy hands. Keep them standing by your power. Lay your hands upon them. This decision they've taken today, let it be permanent in their lives. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Right there where you are, the counselors will discuss with you and tell you what next to do. The rest of us, let's bow down our heads and tell the Lord to remove from our lives anything that can hinder His power in our life. Begin to talk to the Lord now. Thank you,
Jesus.
I gave my life for thee, my precious blood I shed, that thou might ransomed me and quickened from the dead. I gave my life for thee. What hast thou given for
me? There are four prayers I want you to pray.
I do not know in bed to go get back.
Prayers to connect unstoppable testimony. Only four prayers. Don't let anybody's voice be louder than yours. There is no negotiation in this prayer. Any enemy that has made the mistake of following anyone to this program is in trouble. And any power that does not want to let you go is in trouble. Sisters, are you here? Let me hear the sister saying this after me. Every consultation of darkness, against my life, scatter. Can I hear the sister shouting this?
Brothers, can I hear you shouting the same thing? Everybody together now. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and begin to scatter it. Jesus.
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 Thank you.
Jesus,
name we pray.
Glory for Jesus.
Nagadura.
Uh-huh. Say, my face.
Oh, you be
vanish from every satanic monitor. Can I hear you shouting that? In the name of Jesus. Command the force to vanish from the monitor. Makatera katera. In Jesus' name we pray.
Glory for Jesus.
Nagadura. Chumao.
Okumejo.
Double thunder. Double destruction. Pursue my pursuer. In the name of
Jesus.
This is the time to pray. Jesus, then we pray. This is number four. I wish you could see what is happening. Your prayer will be more aggressive. Say, any power reporting me to demons. In the name of Jesus. Yes. Makatesete lakaya moshente rabasa. Papa, rikakareko. Arima sapende kaya moshente. Opuyamata. Mashatisa katela rabo. In Jesus' name we pray.
Glory for Jesus. Agadura.
Father.
Baba.
I'm praying for anyone connected to this gathering. Who is being tormented by wicked intelligent network of the enemy. Receive your deliverance now in the name of Jesus. Receive. Affliction in the head. Affliction in the heart. All the palpitation of the heart. Affliction in the eyes. Affliction in the stomach. Affliction in the womb. Hear the word of the Lord. Get out now in the name of Jesus. Spirit of infirmity. Lose your hold now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you. Thank you.
There is someone here. Enemies are practically eating your flesh and drinking your blood. You came here practically lifeless. I'm going to count seven from here. On my mention, the word seven. Whatever does not have strength in your body will have strength. And you will be completely healed. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. That fellow, check your body. Stretch that leg. Stretch that hand.
No.
Run quickly to the altar. Don't let the devil put it back. Yes, you could not do those things before. You could do them now. Run quickly to this altar. Don't let the devil put them back. Check that swollen place in your body. It has vanished now. Run quickly to this altar. Don't let the devil put it back. Something is happening over there. That's a salty. Take the place in that one woman. That baby in your womb, that sin bed has started to move again. That's the power of God coming upon you. Hear the footsteps of Jesus. He is now passing by. Very bad for the wounded, healing all who apply. As he spake to the sufferer, who lay at the pool, he said, in this moment, we now be made whole. We now be made whole. We now be made whole. Oh, come, weary sufferer, oh, come, sing, sing, sing. See the life stream is flowing, see the cleansing of the world. Step into the forest and the shadow. Your hero has sent Jesus, oh, could I love my Jesus? Only to that father, which won't but it's all my life's song. Here, tea and I go. Oh, we bear his secret. Upon your life, stretch your right hand to me at this altar now. Father, this hand that has stretched forth, let this hand carry the fire of God. Let it carry the power of God. Let it carry the healing virtue of God. Mataya, the carpenter, you and collect the fire of healing. Collect the fire of deliverance. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. 21 times, smite wherever you have problems. Smite it hard. Don't worry about the pain. As you smite, you say, go back to your senders. Go back to your senders. Let's go. This one. Amen. Check your body now. Begin to do what you could not do before. Once your sickness has disappeared, run quickly to this altar. Don't let the devil put it back. Father, I'm praying for anyone in this gathering. You have never really enjoyed your divine benefits. Anytime you want to get into your divine benefits, something goes wrong. Receive your deliverance now. In the name of Jesus, receive it. In the name of Jesus. Get us a pledge. Father, I'm praying for anyone in this gathering who is suffering from the power of unrepentant and stubborn household wickedness. Wherever they are now, receive your deliverance in the name of Jesus. Receive. Aha. That woman who came here with a wasting disease. Check your breath, check your body. You find that the wound has dried up. The wasting disease has gone. Run quickly to this altar. Don't let the devil open it up again. Thank you, Jesus. Father, I'm praying for anyone who is here and the enemy is attacking your marriage. The enemy is firing arrows at your home. Right there where you are this day. Receive your deliverance now.
Receive it.
Jesus. Father, anyone here who is living in a house of demotion, a cursed house, and they cannot move out because of their financial situation,
Father.
Baba.
Let them receive their deliverance. Receive. Father, I'm praying for anyone in this particular program who is suffering from financial embarrassment. Receive your deliverance now. Receive. In the name of Jesus. There is someone in this meeting now. The way you are going to know yourself is this. You just gave your first fruit offering today. But by the coming power must change. You will have become a multimillionaire. Yes. Father, I'm praying for anyone in this gathering who is meant for the front, but the enemy keeps pushing the person behind. Receive your deliverance now. Receive. Thank you, Lord. Something is happening. Father, we cover the signs and wonder the testimonies up with the blood of Jesus. Affliction will never rise again in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. If you have a testimony to share, wait here. The Lord has said, you don't run away. Don't be shy. So that the devil will not bring it back. Quickly bring out your tithes and your offering for this meeting. Father, we thank you for the tithes and the offering. A good measure of praise falling over. Let it be our lot in the name of Jesus. Lay your hands upon our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. As the ushers are going about, we listen to a few of our testimonies. Meanwhile, if you are a firstborn and you are here, bring out your anointing oil in your hand and point it towards this altar now. Point it towards this altar. Father,
Baba,
we stretch this oil towards you. Let this oil become the oil of spiritual catapulting to the next level. Let this oil become the oil of power, the oil of fire, the oil of glory, the oil of promotion, the oil of excellence. In the name of Jesus, I soak the oil in the blood of Jesus. I soak it under the canopy of the Holy Ghost. As you anoint your head and your legs, you will that firstborn, your life will no longer remain the same. You will possess the gate of your enemies. You will possess the gate of your enemies. You will possess the gate of your enemies. In the name of Jesus. thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name we pray. While the ushers are going about collecting the first and the offering, we listen to some of our testimonies. If you are a firstborn, after giving your first and your offering, use that oil to anoint your head and your legs. Bring out your prayer letter now. Bring out your prayer letter and stretch it towards this altar. Father, we stretch our letters before you after the order of Hezekiah. Father, answer by fire in the name of Jesus. Answer by fire in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name we pray. If you are a firstborn, remain standing. If you are not a firstborn, sit down. But let your amen roar like thunder as you sit down. As you can always stand in gap for somebody. Say this after me. I'm a firstborn. I'm the beginning of strength of my household. I'm the excellence of dignity. Excellence of power. I shall not be a deficit unto the world. I shall be as stable as a rock. I shall excel. And no one shall defile me. I shall not die a grievous death. I shall not be an infant of days. Neither shall I be an adult that has not fulfilled his years. I shall have the might of Samson. But not his carelessness. I shall have the wisdom of Solomon. Not his whoredom. I shall have the holiness of Job. And not his calamities. I shall possess the gate of my enemies. I shall not be subject to pain or poverty. The enemy shall not outwit me. The Lord shall not with the oil of gladness above my fellows. The fire of the enemy shall not burn me. My head shall not be buried in shame. I shall be respected and honored in my father's house. I shall be the first among equals. I shall be the preferred among many. My voice shall be heard and reckoned with. As a firstborn, I redeem my destiny by the precious blood of Jesus. I redeem my destiny by the precious blood of Jesus. I redeem my destiny by the precious blood of Jesus. I redeem my destiny by the precious blood of Jesus. I redeem my destiny by the precious blood of Jesus. I dedicate myself this day to the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. And a loud amen. Now begin to pray from this paper very quickly. Whether you are firstborn or not, pray from this paper very quickly. And quickly pray through this prayer. Father, as many as the voices of the firstborn that are being raised to you in prayer now, let them repossess their possession. Catapult them to their correct level. Let these prayers become testimonies to them. Every firstborn connected to this program, beginning from today, backwardness never. You will continue to move forward. Every power pushing you back, I bury them now in the name of Jesus. As a result of this firstborn deliverance you participated in, your testimony shall be huge. I cover all the prayers you have prayed with the blood of Jesus. Let the seal and stamp of heaven be applied to those prayers in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. We commit unto your holy hands the students of King's College who are in this service, who are standing in for their school as a firstborn school. Let the power of God fall upon that school in the name of Jesus. Let it repossess its possession. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Don't forget. Don't forget. At the next two palm of
singers,
deliverance from evil history and childhood bondages or problems. Come with the pictures of your children. If you are still believing God to marry or to have a child, come and stand the gap with your own picture. You will see the amazing things the Almighty will do. It is time to cut off any evil family history from affecting the children. Everybody shout this loud and clear three hot times. Don't worry whether you lose your voice, but shout it three hot times. My testimony is unstoppable by the power in the blood. Shout it three times. Number two. Number three. The Lord blesses you from Zion. Make his face to shine upon you. No weapon come against you shall prosper. The sun will not smite you by day, nor the moon by night. As a result of this palm of singing you have attended, you shall overtake those who are better than you. You shall overtake those who are more skilled than you. All the servants writing on the head of your destiny shall be overturned, and you shall possess your possession in the name of Jesus.
I believe you have been blessed by this video. If you have any question or prayer request or want a particular video topic, use the comment section below. Don't forget to like, comment and subscribe to this channel by clicking on the subscribe button and the notification bell beside it to be updated with new videos whenever available. Thanks as you share this video with your friends and family. God bless you.